Not every company that came public this year is a turbocharged growth play that's hemorrhaging money. There have been a few genuinely compelling IPOs if you know where to look for them. Take Grocery Outlet, GO, for all you home gamers. This is a supermarket chain that I like to think of as kind of the TJ Maxx of grocers. They have a very clever system for sourcing merchandise that lets them offer 40 to 70% percent discounts. 40 to 70. I mean, like, wow. In late July, I told you I loved this business, but said maybe you have to wait a little bit because the stock was at 39. Now, though, Grocery Outlet's been hit with a major pullback. It's taken to 32. And at these levels, I think it looks a lot more enticing. So let's dig deeper with Eric Lindberg. He's the CEO of Grocery Outlet Holding. Learn more about his company and its prospects. Mr. Lindberg, welcome to Mad Money.
Good
to see you, sir.
Thank you very much
okay,
for having me.
First time on the show. I know a lot of callers. I mean, we had a caller, Zach, in California, July 2nd, said, tell us about this store. And then we got a chance to have you. So why don't you tell us about this
store? All right. Well, it's you got it, the TJ Maxx. Of grocery. It's a sourcing model. We have merchants who are knocking on doors all the time at CPGs, consumer product goods manufacturers, looking for great deals. Those deals come into the store and they end up 40 to 70% for the customer. Customers love finding what they can find. Grocery, frozen, deli, produce, meat, you know, everything you'd find in a regular store, but at great, great discounts.
Well, I have to tell you, after reading everything that's about your company, I was two minds. One, I wanted to buy the stock, but two, I wanted to buy a grocery outlet. I wanted to be.
We'll take you.
But tell people about it, because we have people right now who are probably thinking, is there any way I can own one? Because they might have thought, well, I don't want to go against Kroger, but you're not going against a Kroger.
No, you're not. It's an amazing model. We like to say it's like the last American retail dream.
Yes.
For people that have been in the business, they've worked hard all their lives. They've run stores for other people. This is their chance to get in. With Grocery Outlet doing the buying at scale and providing all the deals, they provide the labor in the store, they run it locally, they make a lot of the merchant decisions that are taken away from a lot of retailers today, and we split the gross profit margin on the four-wall unit 50-50. So there's a real upside for them. We have the same incentives to sell more at profit, and it creates just amazing opportunities for 350 families out there.
Well, that's got to be one of the reasons why you've had 15 consecutive years of positive comparable store sales growth in an industry that is, people have been radically inconsistent.
Yeah, we're really proud of that stat. And it is a big piece of the operators delivering that local service and delivering, you know, that feel in each one of the stores. So we give them a lot of credit.
I want people to understand the flavor of this. Talk to me about the contract written on a napkin.
Yes. Jim Reed was in Redmond, Oregon. And I would say today, Redmond, Oregon is still a store in the same town on their third generation. Vince Downs and his wife run that store. His grandfather met the founder of Grocery Outlet. He had a building. We had product. The two of them got together. He said, hey, would you like to sell some groceries from San Francisco? And, you know, Mr. Downs said, I'd love to. They shook hands. They wrote a little contract, you know, share the margin and I'll pay you as a manager. And that turned into the basis of what we have today for 350 families, which is just a...
But why doesn't anyone else have it? Is it just not replicable? Because it's a different style.
Yeah, it's a little more complicated. It's a little more touchy-feely. Yeah. You know, we really get into bed with the operators. You know, they become partners. They don't leave. You know, retailers are all about replicating the predictable.
Right.
We're about sort of getting into that gray zone where you let the operator sort of deliver to that local. So many retailers just don't want to do it because they don't want to mess with it. But I would look at Chick-fil-A and say Chick-fil-A is doing it today.
Good example.
Very, very similar. There are other models out there, but there's no one in grocery doing it.
Okay, so what I have to ask, but everybody in your business, I have to ask, how do you compete with Amazon?
Well, we do. We think we do quite
right?
Well.
You're lower priced than Amazon.
We are, for sure. Yeah, absolutely. We're the lowest price, bar none. You know, Grocery Outlet is the cheapest place to buy food. It is a brick and mortar model, and we're proud of that. We don't have any immediate plans to go online. We don't think you can replicate what we have in the store, that constant turnover.
Treasure hunt.
It's very hard to do. It's very hard for people to select your fresh product and deliver it to your home. And the biggest reason is we don't think anyone's making money doing it. We don't think anyone in our business is making money delivering food. So never say never. We're going to watch it. But right now, we're just having fun, you know, opening stores and doing it the old-fashioned way.
One last question. You've opened a store very close to where I grew up, actually a couple. And how do you get the word out about Grocery Outlet? Because you can't advertise nationally if you only have a couple around the Pennsylvania area.
Yeah, so you do have to. We use word of mouth. The local operator is really powerful. We have a great marketing team. We do a lot with social and digital. We will do some conventional advertising. We'll do some flyers. We'll do some promotional stuff. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook. We're all over sort of all the new digital tools and technologies. And people find you. When you have 40 to 70% savings, people just want to come in and find what you have.
It seemed like there's some people come because it's recession-proof and they need it. It just seems like other people come who are actually quite well off and they like to browse.
Yeah, so I think the value mindset set in really hard in 2009 and it's here to stay.
Yeah, that's so right.
Yeah.
See, that's the new frugality.
Yeah.
People who even have they're doing really well, but they'd rather buy at a grocery outlet.
Yeah.
Why overpay?
Exactly. And then you can get, in the store, you can get a lot of gourmet items. We sell beer and wine. We sell produce.
Right.
We sell this category we call NOSH, natural, organic, specially healthy, which is think of a little Whole Foods inside of a grocery outlet. And those are really discounted products, really good deals. And everyone wants to eat healthy.
Well, you're one of the most exciting companies that have come public this year. And you're also the great ones always are like yours. They're just doing really well. The crazy ones, they're the ones where people lose their shirt on. I don't want that. I want them in grocery outlet. That's Eric Lindberg. He's the grocery outlet CEO. And by the way, they have fabulous stuff online. If you want to learn about them, the grocery outlet story I thought was terrific. You'll understand their model. And if you're like me, when you finish, you'll want to own a grocery outlet. Thank you so much, sir. Stick with Kramer.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.